Welcome back, folks. I think I found what might just be the final nail in the coffin for the Flat Earth conspiracy. I'd love to know what you think, so stick around to find out more. Hi, everyone. I'm Nick Oz. I'm an engineering tech who loves design, CAD, engineering, and I love to follow Flat Earth debunking. If you're subscribed to my channel, thanks so much for sticking around. If you're new here, please consider subscribing and clicking the notification button if you like this kind of content. I'd really appreciate it. My day job in the real world of design, construction, and project management has had me quite busy lately. But that doesn't mean I haven't continued to follow the Flat Earth circus in my spare time. It seems that the world of conspiracies in general has only gained ground lately. I think fear, lack of proper education, along with mistrust in established institutions relating to the current situation in the world, has really helped to fuel that. It's very unfortunate, in my opinion. As part of my debunking research, I've had a chance to look at the crazy world of TikTok. It seems to be a breeding ground for conspiracies and evil plots of all sorts, not the least of which are about the Flat Earth conspiracy. I go under the name of Flurf Alert, if anybody wants to follow me. I've met some very cool people who have joined the Flat Earth debunking army. Check them out in the description below if you'd like to go on a wild ride. If you do check it out and decide to add your 2 cents, you need to be prepared for an onslaught of derogatory comments and insults from many in the Flat Earth community. On the plus side, some of them are actually cordial and ask, dare I say, intelligent questions. It's really quite entertaining, actually. I follow a number of amateur astrophotographers, professional astrophysicists, and engineers on TikTok. The amount of information they provide in their short videos to refute the Flat Earth is absolutely staggering. What's come of this exploration is what I think is the last nail in the coffin for the Flat Earth model, and that is the observation of star trails when we look south in the Southern Hemisphere. I'm also in the process of learning some new 3D software called Blender, and I've made a few models to better explain a few things in this video. I'm just learning, so don't expect any cinematic quality
CGI.
So let's take a look at why observable stars and constellations in the Southern Hemisphere absolutely eviscerate the Flat Earth model. Let's go. When you're in the lower Southern Hemisphere, below the equator, looking due south, and the stars come up in the night sky, you can see the constellation known as Crux, or more commonly known as the Southern Cross, just over the horizon. This constellation gets even more visible as you make your way closer to the Tropic of Capricorn, and beyond to the south. This constellation has been the southern point of reference for nautical navigation for centuries. The Southern Pole Star, known as Sigma Octantis, lies almost exactly due south of the globe. Its apparent position in relation to the celestial pole makes it the Southern Hemisphere pole star. When astrophotographers in the Southern Hemisphere point their cameras due south at the horizon to create long exposure star trails, they take stunning photos and video. Absolutely beautiful. Anyone located in the Southern Hemisphere with a consumer-level DSLR camera that can take long exposures, along with a tripod for stability, can do this experiment for themselves. This exercise is not limited to some expert astronomer shill paid for and employed by evil NASA. And the reason we see these star trails is because the Earth is rotating. The Earth rotates about its axis at a slow
15-degree-per-hour drift.
Thanks, Bob. The light being emitted from the stars leaves a trail on the camera sensor, creating the star trails, thus proving rotation. For clarity, Flat Earthers say it's the stars that are rotating around the Earth, because we're at the center of the universe. When we look at the Flat Earth model, we are told by Flurfers that the Southern Cross sweeps along the horizon along a great circle. But here's the big problem for the Flat Earthers. We never ever see horizontal star trails made by Sigma Octantis or any other constellation when using long exposure photography in the night sky. we see exactly what one would expect to see if we were living on a rotating globe. The globe that rotates at 15 degrees per hour, a 15 degree per hour drift. Flat earthers always yell out with joy and say, we can't be spinning on a ball at 1,000 miles an hour, or we'd feel it, and it would throw us off the planet like a merry-go-round spinning out of control. That's completely wrong, of course. Flat earthers just don't seem to be able to wrap their heads around concepts like conservation of angular momentum. And in fact, this rotation is quite slow, at a measly 0.0006944 rotations per minute. A really interesting fact is that the Southern Cross can be seen simultaneously in the night sky from multiple locations in the Southern Hemisphere by looking due south. Yes, you could be in South Africa and have a buddy in Chile. Both look due south and see the exact same constellation. The only difference in what you would see would be its apparent rotational position in relation to the location in the Southern Hemisphere. Now let's look at the Flat Earth model, and I'll show you why observation of the Southern Cross from the Southern Hemisphere looking south is their biggest problem and completely invalidates their hypothesis on the shape of the Earth. On the Flat Earth model, at least the one the vast majority of them agree on, they use what is known by geographers as an equidistant azimuthal projection. Interestingly, this map represents the actual map of the globe, with the Southern Hemisphere torn away from the globe and expanded outwards to form a circle. The South Pole, instead of being in a single location like it is in reality, is now basically everywhere around the circumference, in an infinite loop around the edge. As if this wasn't bad enough, the map is then flattened out like a pancake with an added terrarium dome to protect us from the waters above, as is described in Genesis. If we use this extremely flawed logic, when we place an observation point of reference looking south towards the Southern Cross at night, the constellation would sweep across the horizon. If we did our long exposure photography session from this position, we'd have to see star trails that look like this. So, if anyone out there can show me any constellation in the Southern Hemisphere looking south, actually doing this in reality, I promise to put my money where my mouth is, and I'll become a flat earther. Furthermore, and it gets even better here, it would be impossible to view the Southern Cross while looking south from multiple locations at night. Period. Let's look due south on our flat earth model from Chile at the Southern Cross in the night sky on the flat earth map. Okay, it's in our field of view. But we know for a fact that the Southern Cross can also be viewed at the same time in the night sky from South Africa when looking south. We need to look directly south. See the problem here? Flat earthers generally agree that you can see this constellation when looking due south from these locations. But what they seem to miss is that it's impossible from two locations while looking directly south. So, how can this guy in Chile be looking directly south, see the constellation, and this guy in South Africa also look directly south to observe it at the same time? The answer is they can't do it on the flat earth model. Period. There's been a few creative-minded flat earthers who have attempted to explain this by using magnifying glasses that demonstrate distortion. These examples do indeed show distortion, but they still get it wrong because their models show view angles from looking outside of the dome. Plus, their domes are always upside down, it seems, which is not a reflection of what one would see anyway, even if we were living under some sort of magical firmament. Eric Dubay, the Flat Earther's hero and conspiracy priest, also tries to explain this. I've looked at all his explanations over and over, but they make absolutely no sense at all. He claims ridiculous theories based on his complete misunderstanding of how perspective works. He's also talking about some sort of personal dome theory, where there's domes within the dome creating this visual distortion. This is also the reason that the Southern Star Trail subject is one that most of them shy away from and try to avoid. So basically, these explanations for distortion caused by the dome are all based on pure conjecture, fueled by philosophical narratives in an attempt to explain a ridiculous model that just doesn't jive with reality. All these explanations are a clear result of confirmation bias, which is defined as the tendency to search for, favor, and interpret information that confirms an existing belief. There's a great website linked below that takes a close look at every single one of Eric Debye's claims. It uses actual science to debunk every single one of those claims. Check it out. Truly, flat earthers. If you really think about it, this all sounds like a weak attempt to explain something that just doesn't work. I thought the whole idea behind the flat earth was to make the universe seem more simple for the below average Joe to comprehend because, one, we don't feel like we're on a spinning ball rotating at 1,000 miles an hour, revolving around the sun on an elliptical orbit at 67,000 miles per hour. I think that's my favorite flat earth argument, actually. They have no concept of the vastness of space, scale, or the laws of conservation of momentum. I'm not going to go into detail on this because it's been explained over and over again elsewhere on YouTube. It seems to me that despite the overwhelming amount of evidence for a spherical Earth in the heliocentric model, there is nothing, no matter how concrete, that will sway them. So basically, it's a lost cause. The most common rebuttal I see from flat earthers is, "Show me the observable, measurable proof of a curve. You can't." I'm not entirely sure what they mean by measurable anyway. The way they interpret measurable is likely impossible. They are probably looking for something like this to show the curvature of the Earth, which is impossible. We can't see the curve on the Earth with our eyes while standing at sea level, or even higher altitudes like 50,000 feet. I'll give them that. The scale of the planet is just too massive, and perspective makes the horizon at sea level look completely flat. But just because you can't see something doesn't mean it's not there. There are dozens of experiments that can clearly demonstrate the curvature of the Earth. I'm not going to waste your time and go into them here, because you can find them all over YouTube. Ironically, flat earthers use the same argument when evangelizing their dome. "You can't see it," they say, "but the Bible says it's there, so it must be there. Plus, what's keeping the atmosphere from getting sucked out into the vacuum of space?" When you give them the answers, which any grade 10 physics student can explain, by the way, the response is always, "Lies, lies, lies, evil NASA, Illuminati, Photoshop, CGI, indoctrination by false education." Education is an interesting point which I think needs to be highlighted. Flat earthers claim that the education system is rigged to spread the lie of a globe. Really? What they are missing here is that a good education teaches us how to think, not what to think. The basis of their education in relation to flat earth comes from the likes of authoritative figures such as Eric Debye, Bob 15 degree per hour drift Nodell, and Quantum Eraser. All highly regarded individuals in the community with zero credentials in the fields of actual science and obvious motivations besides spreading their truth. Education by indoctrination, indeed. Listen, flat earthers. If you think these flurfer evangelists are preaching true education, think again. You are clearly being taught what to think, not how to think. You're being taught what to think based on a philosophical fairy tale that suits a dogmatic narrative. In essence, it's tribal folklore. It's becoming dangerous, in my opinion. There have even been flat earthers handing out pamphlets to grade schoolers in an attempt to indoctrinate
them. I'm going to flashback them. Guys! You don't live on a ball. The earth is flat. I got flyers for you right here. You can check out my YouTube, okay? Some of them picked them up. Hey, give them to the teachers. Hey, you can verify everything on my flyer. Large bodies of water do not curve.
Others have lobbied the education system to include flat earth as an alternate reality in their curriculum. Dangerous indeed. There's a really great video interview by Lee McIntyre, who has studied conspiracy theory and science deniers for decades. In 2018, he attended the Flat Earth International Conference in Denver to observe what he considers the ultimate form of science denial, the flat earth conspiracy. He goes into depth on why people believe in conspiracies and just how dangerous it can be. I'll leave a link to the video in the description below, and I highly encourage you to check it out because it explains a lot about the human condition and how many can fall for the traps of true indoctrination. Well, that pretty much sums up this video, folks. I hope you enjoyed it. If you haven't already, please hit the subscribe button because I plan on making more content really soon. If you have any questions or issues relating to what I've presented here today, please comment below. Thanks so much for watching, and until next time, cheers.